हेलो फ्रेंड्स। सो या इज इट बफरिंग? ओके, सो दिस इज अनदर वीडियो। आई थिंक आई हैव मेड अ स्मॉल वीडियो ऑन दिस अर्लियर। आई मे नॉट बी एबल टू शेयर द स्क्रीन बिकॉज आई एम डूइंग इट लाइव, बट दिस इज ऑन थेसलोनियंस चैप्टर 2। सो आई विल रीड द वर्सेस। ओके, now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and by our gathering together unto him. By the way, I am not a Christian, okay? I am just reading this passage. That ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter, as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come, except there coming a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. So probably Antichrist is going to be revealed first, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, shewing himself that he is God. So Antichrist obviously will say that he is God, he is God, he is the false God or the false Christ. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? And now ye know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Okay, so when the wicked are revealed, probably it will be a solar event, because he is saying the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. So it looks like a sun event, or like a bright flash, or like a comet or something. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders. So God's energy will come after Satan does his work. And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. So this is kind of clearly indicating that those people who are believing the lie, the believing the falsehood, they would not go to probably age of Aquarius probably. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion. So this is the most important part. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie. So what exactly is delusion? So it is not illusion, like it's not like a magic spell, like somebody has cast an illusion. And you can forgive anybody for getting tricked by an illusion. Like I see a rope and I think it is a snake. It's not a delusion. That could be my mind playing tricks. But it can still be an illusion if it is cast by a magician. Right? Delusion is more like, you know, when I believe something, even though somehow it is not true, I am holding upon that belief, even though it is not true. And just because majority believe in that doesn't mean that it is right. Like, see, a billion people have taken vaccine, or a trillion people have taken a vaccine, doesn't make that thing truth, right? So that is the delusion which, you know, this Thessalonian is talking about. I mean, see, let me go back a little bit. See, in childhood, people are given a lot of vaccines. Like they're given, you know, MMR, what is that, BCG vaccine, a lot of vaccines, right? And if somebody told you that you will still get a breakthrough rubella, a breakthrough disease, measles you will get despite taking the vaccine, what will you say to that person? I mean, you take your child to doctor, and doctor gives a vaccine of the BCG or whatever, And he says, now you still, your child will develop this infection after a few years. Somebody gives a child pulse polio drops. And after a few years, he says that, you know what, there can still be a breakthrough infection. Still that person can contract polio. And there are, say, 20% chances of it. Not 5%, 2% or anything. 20% chances. Would you believe that, guy? Or would you accept that? Everybody on this earth right now, 95% of the people are believing this lie. They may be PhDs, they may be highly educated, they may be very well, I mean, they're intellectuals, they are from all fields, every field. They are simply not trusting the adaptive immunity or the natural immunity or innate immunity or anything like that. And not only that, there are many, many facts. Like, okay, there is nothing wrong in taking the vaccine, but the very fact that it is experimental, very fact that if something happens, an adverse reaction happens, even if it is that 1 in a billion person dies because of that vaccine, he is not getting paid by the vaccine company. How many of the common people know that? Why it has been approved under emergency? Why this madness? Because it's a strong delusion. Now, delusion like Joker, for example, in the movie Joker, Joaquin Phoenix, he believed that he's a very good comic, stand-up comedian. He believed that to the core, right? And then what happened in the end, when he was cracking jokes, nobody was laughing, then he got angry, and then he killed the host, Robert De Niro. And I think Robert De Niro acted in that original movie, I forgot the name of the movie, 1980s, where he was acting as this delusional person who believed that he was that good. So now, like, you know, there are facts. See, I have worked with clinical trial organizations. I worked with pharma companies. I worked with healthcare companies. So give me the benefit of the doubt when I say these things. Okay, I'm not a lay person in that way. I have created a lot of content and a lot of stuff for pharma companies, for healthcare companies. In fact, I've worked for, I can't name the organizations, of course. So I have worked on the human vaccines and animal vaccines way back 6-7 years ago. I worked with very reputed pharma companies to work on drug discovery games, vaccine discovery games and all that. I mean, according to their own hypothesis, to come up with a new drug or come up with a new vaccine, it takes minimum 3 to 4 years. Whereas in this case, they came up within 1 year. Nobody questions that. How they came up with that within 1 year, nobody questions that. It is an experimental drug, nobody questions that. The very fact that some of the vaccines were not even tested fully. They were tested only on, say, some animals. And they directly went ahead with the production. Nobody questions that. Nobody questions the fact that even after 2 doses, people are dying or having adverse reactions. Like, if somebody told me that I will give you pulse polio drops and after 3 years, you will get polio. I mean, what is happening? Where is that common sense which has completely gone out of the window? I'm actually shocked. But this was written in the scriptures. That's why I'm not shocked. So that's why my face is not a shocked face. And for this cause, God shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie, that they all may be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. I mean, what is going on? First jab, you can still get COVID. Second jab, you can still get COVID. You call it breakthrough infection. So first of all, I mean, forget about COVID for a second. What about common cold? I mean, for all these years, could you get a vaccine for common cold? But why people, nobody questions it. See, I can still understand if you tell me that out of fear, okay, it's a vaccine passport. You see, if I don't get vaccine, I cannot travel to another country or I cannot travel to another state. I can still understand because it's not a vaccine, but the fear of persecution, fear of damnation, fear of something because of which you're taking it. I can still understand that. But if you continue to argue that, you know, it is safe, it is good, it is going to save you from the virus, so that doesn't somehow sit with me. I mean, forget about any vaccine. I'm not talking about a particular vaccine. Any vaccine. No vaccine protects you. No vaccine. Because they themselves are saying that. Even you should follow COVID appropriate behavior after the first and the second. Still, you have to follow COVID appropriate behavior. You have not given any guarantee. The doctors coming in YouTube, and YouTube is promoting it like anything. Google is promoting it. Everybody is promoting. You have to still follow COVID appropriate behavior because you can still get the infection even after two doses. Then you have to go get the third dose, the booster dose. Then after 6 months, the effect of this vaccine will not be there. Tell me, I took pulse polio at the age of 6 months or 9 months or whatever. I don't remember. I took BCG, and somebody told me that after 6 months you will still get polio. What does it mean? You will still get all these diseases, rubella and diphtheria. I'll give you all this vaccine, we still get it within 2 3 years. No, I won't answer you, Arunan, okay? Because that is not the topic of, I mean, this video. So that's what it is. So the delusion has set in, and many people have bought into the lie. I mean, see, tomorrow, if good people are forced to take the vaccine, they will still take it. But at least they have the reason that they fought and they had some resistance in the mind. And even if they have taken it, it is only because kind of it is forced. I mean, it is a martial law, right? It is a police state everywhere. There are no democracies. All over the world, the rights of individuals, they're curbed. I mean, it is my health. Still, I'm supposed to take, I'm forced to take it because it is mandated or something like that. That's what is happening in US right now. They're mandating it because they are more dangerous. They're dangerous to the society. Wow. Unvaccinated are dangerous to the society. Can't you see the apocalypse movies? What is that? I Am Legend, I Robot, Matrix, all these are playing out in front of your eyes, and still you believe the lie. Okay, thank you.